is Madison, and I'm going to be attending NYU next year for musical theater. And I wanted to make this video so that your audition process can be as seamless as possible and you can do amazing. So today's video is going to have summer preparation tips for you guys. So my first tip is to apply to a multitude of different programs. You've most likely heard of a BFA, which is a Bachelor of Fine Arts, but there's also a BM, a Bachelor of Music, and a Bachelor of Arts, a BA. So a BA is less rigorous than a BFA, and it'll allow you to do a lot more, like if you want to do a second major or something like that. So a BA allows you more time outside of your major. It's easier to double major. And a BFA is more intensive with the musical theater curriculum. And a BM, a Bachelor of Music, is very similar to a BFA. However, it replaces some of the acting with more music theory and piano. And it is really a great thing to look into if you are not a dancer first, because the dance auditions are often just to see your personality and not a comprehensive part of if you're going to get into that school. Going along with that, you should also be looking at non-audition schools, non-prescreen schools, and prescreen schools. So with a non-audition program, if you get to the school academically, you're allowed to be in their musical theater program. Non-prescreen schools can also be just as competitive as prescreen schools, but I would apply to both because you're most likely not going to pass all of your prescreens and you want to have the highest chance of getting into a program that you're going to really enjoy. I ended up applying to around 22 schools and I had about 13 in person. Moving on to my second tip, start creating a list of schools you want to apply to. And I would highly recommend getting a college audition coach because that's how I found out about the BM programs. And it's just a really great tool so that your list suits you well and you are sure you're getting programs and schools that you are really going to thrive in and love. I have linked below the College Audition Coach and ArtsBridge, which are two great resources that you can use to have college audition coaching. Once you have created this list, go on and see if you need to apply academically first before you audition for the pre-screen. If you don't need to apply academically before you can turn in the pre-screen, then don't apply academically until you hear your audition results from the pre-screen. If you don't pass them, you don't have to academically apply, and you'll be saving so much money, trust me. My third tip is to start beginning the Common App in the summer. This will save you so much time throughout the year, and you'll have a weight off your shoulder. Even if you don't know which schools you can apply to yet, start applying to the Common App. It has so much information that you have to fill out. And most schools are going to require an essay that is on the Common App, so you can start writing that and get ahead. I have linked below The Accepted, which is a website where most pre-screens are turned in, as well as the Common App and Coalition, so you can start filling those out. My final tip, number five, is to make spreadsheets for your schools. The last thing you want is to not be organized and mess up an audition because you didn't know what you needed to sing or you missed a deadline or something like that. So I have linked below two different Google spreadsheets that you can make copies of. The first one is just for a comprehensive list of all your schools and if they have pre-screens, if they're part of the Common App or Coalition. So you can use my template and fill it out for your schools. The second one is for keeping organized and making sure you know exactly what they want to see for both pre-screens and in-person auditions. I would make two copies so that you can have one with all your pre-screen requirements as well as the in-person requirements. And what I did is I put at the top the different requirements and then would highlight underneath for each school and what they would need. And then you could put the song title in that highlighted box or any additional information, and that is just so helpful because you don't want to go to an audition and realize you did not prepare enough songs. That's not a great feeling, trust me. There's also a book that I linked down below called The Ultimate Musical Theater Audition Guide that is so helpful. It goes over so many tips, so you should definitely look that up and read it. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope it's helpful. Subscribe so you'll see when my next video comes out with more tips. Like the video and have a wonderful day. Goodbye.